Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll be solving basic compound interest problems using the BAII Plus calculator. Example 1. What is the future value of $600 invested at 8% per annum compounded semi-annually for 4 years and 6 months? To do this, we need to use the time value of money buttons stated here. First, let's clear time value of money by pressing second, clear time value of money to clear whatever has been stored in these entries. Next, we need to set the compounding periods per year. So we go to second, PY, and in this case, it's compounded semi-annually, so we set PY to 2. Enter, scroll down, and ensure that CY is also set to 2. Then we press second quit to leave that mode. Next, we want to input N. So this investment is made for 4 years and 6 months, which is 4.5 years. Okay, so we do 4.5 times the PY. So PY in this question is 2. So we multiply that by 2. We get a 9. Basically, we will have 9 total compounding periods in 4.5 years. The interest rate per annum, 8%, is entered by pressing IY. So we press 8, IY. And then present value is $600. So we put that in as 600, present value. And in this case, we don't have payment. But because we clear our time value of money, we don't need to bother about payment. We can just move on. But if you didn't clear time value of money, you'll have to do zero payment to make sure no payment is included. And then finally, you can compute future value. So the future value is $853.99. Notice that the future value is negative. This is because we entered a positive present value. Now, one of them will be positive, the other will be negative because money is moving in and out. Some people prefer to set PY to 1, so N could be the number of years. So in that case, you have something like this. Second PY, you set that to 1, enter, scroll down, make sure you set CY back to 2. Enter, second quit, and then you can set N to 4.5 years, 4.5 N, and if you compute future value, you'll get exact same result as before. Let's look at another example. Example 2. What is the present value of $7,500 due in 9 years if interest is 6% per annum compounded monthly? So we begin by setting PY. Second POI is compounded monthly, so we enter 12, enter. Scroll down, you can see that CY is automatically set to 12 as well. Second quit. For N, we have 9 years compounded monthly, so we have 9 times 12 total compounding periods. That's 108 N. Interest rate is 6% per annum, so we press 6 IY. If you did not clear time value of money at the beginning, just like I didn't. So you can just do zero payment. And then our future value is 7,500. So 7,500 future value. And then compute present value. So the present value is 4,376.50. And like I said before, some people prefer to set PY to 1. So if you want to do that, so second PY, 1, enter. Scroll down and make sure CY is set to 12, enter, second quit, then make sure N is set to 9 years, and then compute present value. You get the same result as before. Let's look at one more example. Example 3. How many years will it take 300 to grow to $450 if interest is 4.5% compounded quarterly? So this time we want to find the number of years we will be computing N. So again, we start by setting PY, second PY. It's compounded quarterly, so we set PY to 4, enter, scroll down and show that CY is also set to 4, second quit. So the interest rate is 4.5%, so we are 4.5 IY. The present value is 300, so 300. But this time we have to make sure we make one of present value or future value negative. So we make the present value negative, okay? And there is no payment. So if you didn't clear time value of money, make sure you do zero payment. Future value is 450. We put input that as positive, 450 future value. And then we compute N. So N is 36.24 quarters. So it takes 36.24 quarters to grow to 450 if interest rate is 4.5% compounded quarterly. But we want to find this in years. So to do so, we just divide the N value by PY. PY was set to 4. So we just divide this result by 4. Divided by 4. And that's it, 9.06 years. So it takes 9.06 years for 300 to grow to 450 at 4.5% compounded quarterly. Again, if you prefer to set PY to 1, second PY 1, enter, scroll down. You have to set CY to 4 because it's compounded quarterly. Enter. So in that case, if you compute N, you will just get the number of years. So I'm going to quit this and compute N. There you go. So it gives us 9.06 years. And that's basic examples in compound interest. Thanks for watching.